those who are listening to us online. Praise the name of the Lord. Let us pray. Father, we thank you this morning that we have a great opportunity to hear your word. At a time like now, when the whole world is shutting down, we turn to you, you who is our help. And we pray this morning that your word will give us strength as we look for solution. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome to the sermon this morning. Our reflection is on God's presence in crisis. Our text for today is Psalm 46, beginning at verse 1. David said, God is our help and our strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her. She will not fall. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar. Kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice. The earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come and see what the Lord has done, the desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks down bows and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. He says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. This is the word of the Lord. This morning, I begin with an illustration. One day, a story is told of a construction worker who was employed on a high-rise building project, which required him and others to work after dark. He was busy on the edge of one of the walls, which was many stories high, when he suddenly lost his balance and fell. And he fell over the edge. He managed to grab the edge of the wall with his fingertips. Desperately, he hung on, hoping that somebody would discover his perilous situation. He was in total darkness, barely hanging on to the wall and crying for help. But no one would hear him due to the noise and the machinery at the construction site. Very soon, his arms began to grow weak, and slowly his grip began to slip. He tried praying, but no miracle occurred. At last, his fingers slipped from the wall, and with a cry of horror, he fell down. He fell exactly 3 inches to the scaffold that had been there all this time. But he did not know or seen it because he was in darkness. Brothers and sisters, trouble comes to everyone at some point. No one escapes trouble. If you are not having a bad day today, you will have it one day. And what will you do then? Will you fall apart? Will you give up on God? Will you give up on the world? Will you give up on yourself? The writer of this psalm speaks to our own reactions when life beats us down. And I'd like to raise three points that are important as we reflect on Psalm 46. The first point that the psalmist makes is slow down during times of crisis. I love verse 10. The psalm writers had been bragging of how God was proceeding in the first 9 verses. And then God takes over and he says these 8 powerful words: be still and know that I am God. When life is falling apart, it is hard to be still. It is hard to remember that God is God. We want to do more. We want to be more in control. So when God says, slow down, be still, that one is very hard for us to hear because of the noises that are surrounding us. If anything, we want to speed up, but God is saying to us, be still and know that I am God. The second point that the psalmist says is stay calm. The first one was slow down. Then he says the second one, stay calm. In verse 2, the poet describes an earthquake. The earth is giving way and the mountains are falling into the sea. He describes in verse 3, roaring waters and quaking mountains. It sounds like hurricanes, tsunamis, and volcanoes. Let me tell you, earthquakes make you feel really small and out of control. Nature can bring fear, and nations can bring fear as well. Verse 6 describes nations in uproar and kingdoms falling. But look back to verse 2. The writers know that God is with them, whether in natural conflict or man-made conflict. And because of that, they proclaim in verse 2, therefore we will not fear. Let me tell you this morning, you have only one choice. You cannot have fear and faith at the same time. When faith comes in, fear goes away. And the vice versa is also true. And so during times of calamities, we have a choice, either to be led of fear or to be led by trusting and believing in God. No matter what happens in your life, no matter how small and out of control you feel at this time, we can remember that God is with us. Remember point number 1, slow down. Point number 2, stay calm. Point number 3, lean on God. That is what the young shepherd boy David did. When he faced down Goliath, he knew his nation faced a big problem. He knew he was no match for a giant. He believed his God was bigger than the problem that he was facing. Look at the very first verse of today's Psalm 46. It says that God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in trouble. God is bigger than your problem. God is stronger than whatever is threatening you or threatening this nation. God is our safe place. God is our safe place. We can go to him in times of crisis. Sometimes we wonder, where is he? But the truth is, he is an ever-present help. God is your refuge and your strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Some of you have been through horrific experiences. Maybe you have lost a child, or you have lost a spouse, or you have lost your own health, or lost a job, or lost your life savings, or maybe you have lost your reputation. Some days, it may seem like you are losing your own mind, and you wonder about God's timing and God's presence and God's strength. Did you forget about me, you may ask? Or is this just too big a job for you to handle? No, God has not forgotten you. And nothing is too big for God to handle. Your story is not over yet. It may feel like it is over, but it is not over. It is not over until God says it is over. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we rest our souls before you. Just now, in the quietness of this moment, help us to give every anxiety to you. Help us to trust you with the troubles that has come our way. Some self-generated and some generated by other people or other factors beyond our control. Help us to remember you are here. You can calm our souls and you can deliver us as we trust in you. Our world needs you at this moment. So we ask for your help for those around us. We pray this in the name of God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you very much indeed, Provost, for that sharing and for bringing God's word to us this morning. Indeed, God is reminding us to be still, to know that he is God, to slow down. We now want to lift our corporate prayers to the Lord. So from wherever you are, the comfort of your home, where you're watching, please may we believe and pray. God, we thank you this morning as you speak to us from the riches of your word. And as you remind us to know your sovereignty, that you are God and in charge of everything, that we slow down, that we lean on you, and that we recognize that you are in charge. We pray for the members of the cathedral from wherever they are, that God, you extend your hand of care upon each one of them. Lord, even though we are not gathered here, all of us physically, as you always do every Sunday, we do know, Lord, that you're teaching us a new way of becoming church. And we pray for them wherever they are in their family settings, in their spaces, that God, you will speak profoundly to each one of them, even from your word that we have heard. May you nurture our members spiritually, that during this time of being away from corporate worship here in church, no one will slide away from you, but they will connect with you and that they will recognize your sovereignty and allow you to be central to their lives. We pray for the families of our members, wherever they are, that Lord, you provide for each of their needs. We pray that you look upon your people who gather in this cathedral in your name, take care of their welfare. Those who are unwell, we pray for your healing and restoration. We pray that during this time of slowdown and potential shutdown, that God, you will take care of our businesses, that we will not lose clients, that you will preserve our jobs wherever we work, that God, we will not be thrown off the cliff. We pray for your protection upon the members of this cathedral from this threat of corona. Help our members, Lord, to take the necessary precautions as has been shared and circulated by the Ministry of Health. We pray for our nation, Lord, at this time that we are facing one of the greatest dangers of our time. We ask of you that, God, you help the citizenry of this nation to cooperate with government in taking the necessary precautions, that, Lord, no one will be careless with their lives and in their attitude, that we will stay away from public gathering, that you will help the members of this nation, the citizens of this country, to observe high levels of hygiene. We ask of you, Father, that you reward the excellent efforts by the government to contain the spread of corona. We thank you for the Ministry of Health. We thank you for the presidency and what they've been able to do in securing and helping our people. We pray, Father, that you may bless their efforts and keep our nation safe. We pray, Lord, that as we move on, we will see a complete slowdown of the spread of this virus. Lift us as a people of hope and help us, Lord, to seek your face more during this time. So may you take charge of Kenya. May you take charge of other nations of the world and protect them under your care. We lift China, we lift Italy, we lift Spain, we lift all other nations of the world that are suffering, that are affected to you, that you be their God, that you be in charge as you bring an end to coronavirus. May you hear our prayers that we now lift to you as a family of faith, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Just a few announcements. First and foremost, the cathedral is not closed. The cathedral is open for your individual prayers. Feel welcomed to your cathedral. Every morning, starting tomorrow, through to Saturday, we will be giving you online reflection every morning. Kindly connect with us through YouTube, through Facebook, and in our websites. Many Christians have been asking how they can continue to support the work of the CTC and how they can give their tithes and offerings. Kindly note, if you'd like to give towards the cathedral in terms of tithes and offerings, you can use the pay bill 303036, and or you can write a check to the All Saints Cathedral. If you'd like to give for your CTC, you can use the pay bill 303035 or write a check to our All Saints Cathedral account. The work of God will continue. No threat is too big for our God. We wish you a blessed week. Keep safe and remain firm in the Lord. And now, to God who is able to keep you, we commend you to him. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord protect you. May the Lord protect this nation from the east to the west, from the north to the south. May the blood of Jesus Christ surround our borders. May the efforts that have been put protect Kenyans. But more importantly, may the blood of Jesus Christ be upon our people. We speak God's blessings and God's peace in your situations. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.